Hello, everybody. My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already, and welcome back to the second installment of Ratchet & Clank. Freaking Ratchet. God. A certain someone has an obsession with the word Ratchet. Friend of mine. You may know him. I shall not name names, however. I hate the use of the word Ratchet in slang, because I've been hearing it more and more lately, too, in, like, the media, and kind of like in late night talk shows and whatever, kind of when they talk about the news and like what's happening in pop culture and crap like that. I hate the use of the word rat. I don't even know how to use it properly.
Like, she's so ratchet.
You know, where I come from, a ratchet is a wrench. It's a wrench that makes a clicky noise when you turn it. Helps get bolts off of things. Which actually is kind of funny that you're Ratchet and you get bolts. Get it? I didn't put two and two together until just now. But you're Ratchet. And he's got a wrench too, so man, I don't know. They were really thinking with this one. Alright, so down here at the end of this cave, and I'm actually pretty sure this is the only reason why we come here, is to grab a gold bolt if you get out your bomb glove. It's hidden in the wall. Ta-da! Our second gold bolt. We are coming right along. Sadly, that is all we're going to be able to get on this planet right now. Because I'm pretty sure we don't have the means to get the skill point. And the other gold bolt we're going to have to come back to... The other gold bolt we're going to have to come back to later. Sadly. There's an awful lot of backtrack if you want to get everything. But one thing I do like about this game is that there is no backtracking for just completing the game. If you want to just play through the game and you don't need 100% it or anything, there is zero backtracking. And I don't have a problem with backtracking. There, you know, some of my favorite games have a lot of backtracking in them, like Banjo-Tooie. But, you know, if I can avoid it, I definitely will. I think that would be the better way to do it, just because... You know, you don't want to have to go back through and play these levels multiple times. Although, really, if your game is a lot of fun, going back through and playing levels over and over and over and over and over again is not a problem. Like, Super Meat Boy is a great example of that. You play those levels probably 100 times before you actually complete them. Some of them, anyway, the harder ones. Because it's just so freaking hard of a game. But when you've completed the level, the last thing you really want to do is come back and do it again. Kind of takes you out of the moment, you know? But if there's optional stuff that you can go back to if you want, you know, if you want to upgrade your things, that I'm perfectly okay with, and this game has some of that. Not necessarily to upgrade anything, but if you want to get all the gold bolts and you want to get all the skill points, you have to come back later on to grab them. Anyway, so if you want, you can come back to this later, but the gold bolts is actually at the end of this river here, but there's a current in the water that we can't fight until we have an upgrade from later, a gadget, if you will. The gadget, of course, I'm talking about is the Hydro Pack, which we don't get until way late in the game. So I decided I'm going to show a clip here of me on a different file where I already have the Hydro Pack, using it to get through the current in the river to get up to this cave, where we can find ourselves a gold bolt. I kind of want to keep things in line with this Let's Play, so you're going to see a lot of clips showing the future of things that we can't get and we have to backtrack for. And there we go, we've got ourselves a gold bolt. Speaking of bolts, I'm going to try to collect as many bolts as possible. I'm skipping over a lot of them here, but I'm going to need them, especially if I want to get weapons or anything. If you are new to the Ratchet & Clank series, one thing that this game doesn't have that all of the other ones do is an upgrade system. You can upgrade your health and your weapons in every game in the Ratchet & Clank series except for this one. That's one major, major addition that I think makes this game less fantastic compared to the rest of the series. But there is a certain charm about the first game in a series like this. Kind of like how Banjo-Kazooie will always be my favorite Banjo game, even though Banjo-Tooie is wildly more popular and bigger and more badass than the first. It's just because it's got a certain charm, you know? And I think that's why I like this game a lot. But there's just so many upgrades later on in the series. So if you play this game, if you're new to the series and you decide to pick this game up and play along with me, don't be thrown off by, you know, some of the awkward controlling of it, because it gets a lot more fast paced in the second game. A lot more faster paster? faster pacer? That is not a term that anyone uses ever. I'm making up words here. That is what we do over here on the Josh Jepson channel. Oh, hello. Suddenly ship. That was definitely not there before. Also, how was that ship flying? There were no jets at all shooting out of that thing. Oh, I thought I was still in the cutscene. Speaking of cutscenes.
Don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. Oh. What are you? Mercenaries? Torturers? Assassins? I'll tell you anything. Here, take my infobot. It's all I've got left.
Sir, we're not assassins.
Hold on. Let's see what he's got.
Has this ever happened to you? Hi, I'm Captain Quark, and believe me, there's nothing worse than staring down a Blargian snaggle beast from the inside, and knowing your equipment isn't functioning properly. That's why I come to Al's Robo Shack for all my electronic needs.
Al's Robo Shack.
Exclusive repair shop for my super electro gadgets since I was knee-high to a sand mouse. If Al can't fix it, it's not broke. Right, Al? You said it, pal. So if you're fighting crime, or just fighting grime, come to Al's Robo Shack in Metropolis for all your robotic repairs. Al's Robo Shack. It's Quarktastic!
Do you know what this means?
Yeah, Captain Quark is really sold out.
Hey,
no,
that's what
it means
I said.
Captain Quark is on Metropolis. We could tell him about this invasion.
If we had a ship.
What? A ship? What? You're not going to torture me?
No, you silly old man.
Chairman, I mean,
I guess if you're conditioned to believe
ship.
That everyone
cool.
that comes
you
to your planet is going to attack you,
right.
then
Thank
you probably
you
would think that
chairman
a little tiny...
Shipliness.
What is he, a tiger? No, I know, he's a Lombax. He's a space tiger! He's got stripes. And they're great! You know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about. Them frosted flakes, yo. I haven't had Frosted Flakes in so long. Guys, what's your favorite cereal? I know, this is a very important question that I must know. What is your favorite kind of cereal? I'm partial to Captain Crunch myself. Captain Quark! I'm sure that Captain Quark has his own cereal. If he doesn't, he should. That would be amazing. Alright, so, like I said, we didn't get everything on this planet right away, but what I can do is pick up the Pyrocitor before we leave this planet. Ta-da! I forgot about that. It actually does do the ta-da thing. That's where I came out. I was just like, why is that open? Alright. Anyway, so we got two Infobots on this planet, so there are two planets that we can go to. Choices already in the game, which I'm okay with. We have plenty of choices. Let us go to... I usually like to go to Metropolis first, because there's a number of things that we get there that we need for this planet anyway. So we'll just go there now. And I'm pretty sure we can do this whole planet without getting anything from Iridia. Even though I like that planet. Though Metropolis is a staple in the Ratchet & Clank series and the Ratchet & Clank universe... Because Metropolis comes back later on in some of the later games. It's like one of the only planets that does. Or I guess Kurwan is the name of the planet. Metropolis is the city. It's the only place that actually comes back in later games. And actually becomes a center focus of some of them too. So, this is a super important place. And also, really, really cool design. I just like the atmosphere of these worlds. Because it's so good for a PS2 game, right? You know, with even the limitations of the PS2, they were able to make an environment that was so beautiful and so full of life. Like, just look at this. Just take a moment. There's a blimp. There's a goddamn blimp. Look at that. Actually, there's a skill point for destroying a blimp. But we don't have a good enough weapon just yet. We need like a rocket launcher or something that we get later on in order to get that. There is, however, a gold bolt, but I don't think we can get it just yet. All right, so two pathways. Let's just go to Al's Robo Shack first. Here we have another weapon that we can grab, but we're not going to have enough bolts to get it just yet. The blaster is actually a weapon that I'll probably use most throughout the game, just because it's one of the more universal weapons. Because you don't really start off with a gun in this game. You start off with the bomb glove, which is kind of a crappy gun. It's not even a gun, it's a glove. How do you throw bombs, like magic bombs, out of a glove? You know, I'm not even gonna argue it. He's a space tiger. Space tigers can do anything. Quote, Josh Jepson, 2014. Space tigers can do anything. They have magical properties. It's true. That's why everybody wants their skin. Or fur, or whatever. They want to wear their fur. God. Just, I love the ships flying all around the city. If you just take a look, I mean, I know I'm in the middle of the battle here, but if you just take a look at the background while I'm fighting these assholes, just the ships flying around gives so much life to the city. It's not dead. It doesn't feel like you're just walking through another level. Which there are some games out there, even some of the best games of all time, that feel that way. That, you know, they're designed around the idea of you being alone in this place. And, you know, that's all well and good and all, but, you know, if you add some humanity to it, sense of there are actual people here, or robots. I mean, robots are people too, right? Do I need to kill that helicopter? Is he going to come back to me later? Oh, he wasn't really all that dangerous, to be honest. Here, I'm going to turn off the help desk notifications because I don't need them. And anything that needs to be explained, I'm sure that I will talk about it. Because it's just annoying me. Like, it's distracting me every time it pops up trying to give me hints about how to play the game. Excuse me, good sir. I don't have time for you. Ratchet's wrench is one of the most versatile weapons you can have in the game. Like, you could probably go through the entirety of this game without using your gun. Well, not against the final boss. But, you can go through the majority of this game just using your wrench. In fact, there's actually some skill points, I believe, at least one skill point you need to just use your wrench on a bunch of dudes instead of shooting them. Even though it would be totally easier just to beat them up with the bomb glove or something.
Ratchet, that's the man we saw on the Infobot. Remember? He knows Captain Quark.
He's TV famous.
You're a robot guy, right?
No, actually, I build robots. I myself am not a robot guy, per se.
Nerd.
Nerd.
Oh my god.
So now that we've cleared that up.
You know, it's like this game is freaking written for me.
We saw your Infobot announcement.
I forgot that the characters have said half the stuff. And every time I keep quoting them before they even say it, without even realizing it.
Commercial. Say, do you run on standard XP-18 sister boards?
Version 7.66.
Back at ya. I may be able to help you out after all. How does a helipack upgrade sound?
Upgrade?
Natch. Since he's a 7.66, I could have the little guy up and flying in no time. Of course, I'll just need my fee for service.
And he's going to charge me out the butt for the helipack, but unfortunately, it's required.
Okay, this won't hurt a bit.
Hey, wait.
It better not. I mean, he's a robot. That would be weird.
Ratchet, am I cool
now? That's one thing I wouldn't understand.
Yeah, you the man.
Why they would ever make a robot that has, like, sensors in them for feeling pain? How would they even replicate that, I wonder? I don't know. That stuff is so fascinating to me. Like, how humans are so... I don't know. Human. I don't think they'll ever make a robot that would, you know, be able to replicate a human, kind of like they do in various sci-fi television shows and whatnot. Whatnot. Now, where is the bit where I have to go? Actually, I think I need to be up there to get the skill point. There's also a gold bolt around here somewhere. If I miss anything, the pop-ups will describe where these things are to the best of their abilities. But like I said, at least for the gold bolts, I'm going to come back for those later. And the skill points, I'm always going to show on the screen anyway, so regardless, there are a couple of skill points, however, that I can grab anyway, and I'll just do it when I can, if I remember to. One of them is up here. If you remember, the cutscene that we watched on the Infobot to get here, the Infobot that we used to unlock this location. See that spinning oh my god. See that spinning robot down there? We need to get down there. And now that we have the helipack, we can actually just float down there. I should have probably done a long jump first. Looks like I'll make it. My trajectory patterns are predicting that we will land on the robot in about 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2. Oh, I was a little bit short. But anyway, if you stand in between his legs like a goddamn pervert, you'll get a skill point. Huzzah! And an achievement, apparently. Which I didn't even know. Well, not an achievement. There's trophies, I guess, on the PlayStation 3. My bad. Sorry, PS3 fanboys. I think I'm going to go ahead and end the episode here. But I thank you guys for watching this episode of Let's Play Ratchet & Clank. And I will see you guys in the next one. How do you throw bombs, like magic bombs, out of a glove? You know, I'm not even gonna argue it. He's a space tiger. Space tigers can do anything.